Yes, we must learn from TV dramas and soaps. That's right. I made this video after watching the latest episode, the latest drama called Liar. I've left a link below the Daily Mail where viewers were on the edge of their seat. Some even said, oh my God, I can't watch anymore. The reaction from the viewers is, it's unbelievable, really, considering the ISIS bomb on the train didn't seem to get the same reaction. Now, it's not because they don't care about those on the train that were injured and could have been killed. It's nothing to do with that. I think I've cracked this. I've got on what's happening here. Why these dramas and soaps are so captivating and so addictive and get people's attention in a way. Mass murder calls. There could be a nuclear war with North Korea tomorrow and they don't care. They're waiting for the next episode of Liar to come out. Also with the soaps you've got the latest storyline, Eva. She's found out her fella's having an adulterous affair with Marie and they're going to get married, so she's going to spring her revenge while they're walking up the aisle and so on and so on. These storylines are really, really captivating. They're very childlike, really, teenage style storylines, aren't they, really? You plot all that when you're a teenager, 14 or 16 or something. But anyway, just getting back to these dramas. You see, I believe why they're so successful in getting people's attention is because they're personalised, where you either can relate to it, it's personally happened to you, or you'd like it to happen to someone that's done the dirty on you. Liar, that's the latest one, is this surgeon supposed to have raped this teacher, and you have to work out which one's telling the truth. And there's parts of the drama that are full of suspense and got you on the edge of your seat and so on and so on. I think there's a short video of it in the mail link I've left below. And so on and so on. Now, as I've said, I believe why they're so successful is because they're personalised. They're getting people's attention. And also, the storylines are all about betrayal and revenge. Now, that may be some sort of natural instinct in us, the Freudian psychologists or psychoanalysts have got onto. May go back prehistoric times where betrayal and revenge, I don't know, it's worth looking into that, but there's some reason why they're so addictive and so captivating, and I believe it's because they're personalised, and that's what we've got to do. We've got to personalise our message to our people, and if people, if there is some instinctive trait in us about betrayal and revenge, then we've got to direct that towards the politicians, haven't we? Of course we have. But anyway, you see, to believe the public or people think in a way of like save the white race in a collective way, a cohesive way, is delusional. Or the white race is going to be a minority in 40 years' time. They don't care. Or about female genital mutilation, that's never affecting anyone they'll ever know in their lives. Or honour killing even. Or even ethnic crimes in some ethnic ghetto. It doesn't affect 99.9% of the public personally. So I believe these dramas and soaps are moving people because they're personalised. Right? They're done very good. They really, really are. I was in a friend's last night and my friend's girl, I hope you're not watching this, she was watching it and she's shouting out loud, you liar, you did, you liar. That doesn't make it a bad person or whatever. They're being brainwashed and manipulated by this stuff. But we've got to learn from it. We've got to personalise our message now so it gets to our people on a personal basis. Not believing this outdated nonsense that they think as a collective group. They don't. They think on a personal level now. And I think this is why these dramas and soaps and all that are so effective. Same with the music industry. Like I've said, you think it's singing about you and maybe an ex-partner you've had a bust up with or something. And the same with these dramas and soaps. And also there's a kiddie theme to them as well, which, you know, maybe part of our psyche, I don't know, but we've got to learn from this. We've got to personalise our message so it's right to the heart of our people and direct their anger to the politicians. Okay, thank you. I hope I explained that as best as I could. Tricky subject, really, but anyway, okay, thank you.